type of offensive system that Georgia Tech uses is extremely challenging for us because of, it has a little bit of the Princeton type system that spreads the floor and makes it very difficult for you to make any defensive mistakes at all. Then they have another system that's similar to what they call the spread offense that Oregon uses, and they keep rotating between the system where they move the ball and they challenge every defensive principle. Back cuts, back screens, penetrations, ball reversals, and it's more of a pattern, and it's very difficult to overplay. The first half, I thought our guys did an exceptionally good job of getting deflections and steals, and we got, I think, I don't know how many points, we had quite a few points at halftime off turnover. You don't normally get a lot of deflections and steals on that type of system, so I thought our guys were locked in. But once they broke out of the offense and started taking the ball to the basket, that's where I thought we faltered a little bit. I look at the out-rebounders, and one of the radio show, the guy asked me, was I concerned about it? Well, this guy, Okiki, was just a superior athlete. He went and got some rebounds that I'm not real sure that they weren't pro-type rebounds. We had him boxed in and boxed out, and he just made some great plays. I thought my guys fought pretty well, and we've been doing a very good job rebounding, but I thought we got out-rebounded by a superior athlete. I don't think we played as well as we're capable of playing, but I think their system had a lot to do with it. I'm very happy to pull away with a victory. This is typical ACC games. We were up about 10 at halftime. I thought that Ike went in the game and kind of plugged the middle up, had a lot of deflections and changed shots the first half. We were able to extend the lead. We got a couple turnovers, got some easy baskets. I knew they weren't going to go away. I thought when we came out the second half, they had a little bit more energy than us. We called a timeout. I thought our guys adjusted pretty well. We'll look back at the end of the season and we'll realize this is a very, very important game for us because these guys are going to beat some people along the way.
Questions, please.
Stat stuffer is a term you've kind of thrown around a lot with Terrence, but for him to have the career day in scoring and also lead the team in assists and rebounds kind of sums that up.
I made that comment when he was a freshman that he was a stat stuffer, and he's becoming more and more of a stat stuffer. But now he's improved in all areas. He has a high basketball IQ, plays with a tremendous amount of effort and focus. Now he's starting to talk and communicate with his teammates a lot more. And I think he's still his best basketball is ahead of him. He's improved his perimeter shot a lot, but he's playing to his strengths right now. You know, he's a guy who's moving the ball, making decisions, defending well, and rebounding well. And that's what you like to see from a kid. Who's diehard Seminole.
Coach, talk about that possession that you guys had where it's just a whole lot of hustle. And I think it took up like about 33, 34 seconds of the clock. And then the kid's name hit the Angola, hit the three. Talk about how much that changed the game.
Well, what you're talking about is that we had 8 possessions in the second half where we passed the ball more than 6 times. And we scored on 6 of them. We moved the ball, made an extra pass, created high percentage shots. Some we drove to the basket, and we got some uncontested shots, and our guys knocked them down. We try to make as many passes as possible. I think we made over 220 passes the night. And when you move the ball that well, you normally shoot a high percentage from the floor. We like to increase that a little bit. We still, a team is still evolving. I think our big guys can be a little bit more involved than what they were tonight. And I think that's a team thing. It's no fault of theirs. This wasn't a good game for them. But I thought that we had some hustle. We got some deflections, some steals that I thought were timely, especially at the end of the first half and during a period where I thought they made some run-ons in the second half. We got 2 or 3 steals and deflections. We got some easy baskets. Plus, I thought we did a very good job of moving the ball.
Coach, you had a... You know, last game it's MJ Walker with a career high. This game it's Terrence Mann. I know Phil's had some big games this year. It seems like a different guy can step up every night on this team.
Well, I said at the outset of the season, we would be a game that could win games by committee. That we the way our system is set up, that we've had a lot of different guys be lead scorers because we try to move the ball and get everybody involved. Sometimes it's CJ, sometimes it's Fiondu, sometimes it's somebody else. And if we can continue to keep playing that way, we'll figure out how to take advantage of everybody's strengths. And we just got to involve our big guys a little bit more. It didn't hurt us as much tonight because their big guys, they were in foul trouble as well. So if we move forward, we got to have a little bit more of a balance inside and outside of
town. Would you prefer a team like this where maybe there's not one go-to guy, or is it nice to have like a Tony Douglas
that
can be
the go-to guy on this team is the guy with the highest percentage shot. That's the way I like it. It's much more difficult to prepare for, and it's a little more challenging as you prepare for a team when you have a lot of guys that are shooting high percentages and they move the ball and take advantage of what the defense gives them.
Leonard, you guys have talked a lot about using defense to create offense. It's not a good example of that as far as forcing turnovers.
And this was a challenging team for us to force turnovers because their system doesn't normally give you deflections and steals because they have such great spacing and they have so many different entries. They can back doors and side entries, and they normally enter the ball through the high post with their big guys. And there were percentages of the game tonight. I thought we just made them catch the ball a little farther out than the operating area, and then some that we did tonight.
Was still okay?
We had guys that cramped. Fiondu had a cramp, and so did Phil. That's the challenge of playing so many games in a short period of time. That full game, an 8-day stretch, was extremely challenging, and I thought those guys gave great effort. We have to manage that. That's as much to do with our game preparation as anything, how we manage a hard-fought game tonight, then making sure that we are prepared physically, mentally, and emotionally for the game on Saturday.
Coach, how big is a win against Virginia Tech and Georgia Tech?
Excuse me?
How big is a win against Virginia Tech and Georgia Tech?
I'm not trying to disrespect your question. What you have to understand, every win you get in the ACC is bigger than huge, if that's a such thing. You know, because this is the new ACC. You're glad and happy, you need to celebrate any game you win at all. Because this is, we had a 16-point lead there for a minute, but this team was not gonna go away. You see more hard-fought games, you see more teams at the top losing to teams at the bottom. There are no more upsets. You just gotta be clawing and scratching and clawing and try to win every game. Every team you play in the ACC will be capable of handing you a hand. Now, obviously, Pittsburgh has a new coach, new program. They're establishing themselves. But Wake Forest hasn't won very many games. But you can't tell that by the way they played. And with 10 minutes to go, it's a dog fight, and they're clawing and scratching and scratching and clawing. That's the new ACC. Every game is huge.